Hey, one second, guys.
Oh, sure, yeah, I'll just go fuck myself, no big deal. What? Oh, sorry, I'm here.
Mildly amusing.
Oh, thank God, man. What's up, everybody? Jim Flanagan over here. Welcome to another podcast recording here. We got a great panel guest here for you guys. It's the 239 Podcast. I hope you guys are listening in. It's season number 3 here, and things kicked off here. I know we haven't had a show in quite some time, but hey, the season's just getting started here, and I'm looking at the standings, looking at some of these scores. We're going to go over that. Let me introduce the guests here. As always, man, Mr. Excitement, Giant918, what's going on there, brother?
www.239hockey.net. Follow us on Twitter at 239hockey. The fact of the matter is, 239hockey fam, is that Daly's got some whack-ass garbage over there at his crib that he cannot get his beautiful face online today, fellas. So we were unable to do that. So thank God and thank you, Jesus, for Jim Flanagan, a.k.a. Mr. Hollywood himself, for producing this podcast today. Lots of exciting things over here. Season number 3. Some teams got six games in. Some teams only have 3 games in. It's an exciting time here at 239 Hockey, Flanny.
That's right. Hey, Giant, I don't know how much of it was technical difficulties or Daly just didn't have his hairdo done, man. But that's the next guy on here. I got a lot of questions on the show for this man. There's a lot of questions coming about. Has the island been exposed? We're going to discuss that. You know, is it questionable? Just like the Chicago Bears with their decision making. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. X Daly, welcome to the show.
You got Mr. Jim Flanagan always trying to stir the pot. The fact of the matter is the island's intact. You know, we didn't win the series, but we'll go about that later. As far as taking Trubisky number 2 and trading away everything, it's just the Chicago Bears move. I'll just go kill myself now because that's just what we fucking do. We just suck at football. So, yeah, there's some big games on the slate tonight. Looking forward to talking about it. Just looking up and down the league right now, I'm seeing a lot of interesting things and a lot of exciting things, if I do say so myself. So, thanks, Flanny.
Okay, and lastly, on the show here, newcomer to the 239 Podcast, and also a new captain this season. A lot of guys question him, however, has done a great job so far here starting out Season 3. I'm talking about Mr. Pale Poner. Pale, what's going on there, brother?
What's going on, Holly? What's going on, Dales? Giant, how y'all doing? It's 239 Hockey. I'm having a good time, man. This is my first season as a captain, and, I'm having fun, man. It's been an exciting season so far. But, looking forward to what happens next.
Definitely, definitely. And we'll get to that team in this show here. We're going to discuss actually quite a few teams, so hopefully if we could recap all of them, would be great. But first thing on the show, I want to discuss here. I know it's early, man. The season just started. Like Giant mentioned, some teams have the six games already played. A couple of them finishing up tonight. Tonight's the last night for week number one. I'm looking at the standings here. I'm looking at some of these scores. And one thing that comes about every season, last season, this season, and that's parity. We're talking about parity in the league. We're always trying to get that on here because, you know, nobody wants to see blowouts or teams like the Jager Bombs and stuff. Starting off with you first, Daly, what do you think about the parity here this season as opposed to the prior seasons or any season there before?
Well, you know, it's funny because, like, when I look at, you know, the teams in the draft analysis that I did and how everybody did in the draft, and I look up and down, I think I did give Cameron the business a little bit, a.k.a. Shock on his team. Other than that, it looked to be pretty good, man. Like, there's a lot of teams that I had, like, you know, 4-6, 5-7, and the first week is really reflecting of that. I had teams that are 5-1, Pales team 4-1-1, Blazing Saddles 3-3. So what I'm seeing is a lot of parity. I'm seeing a lot of even series. Last season, teams jumped off to heavy starts, Jello Time, Thundercats, teams like that jumped out and ran away with it, losing 3-4 games all year. I just don't think that's going to happen this year. I think the teams are deeper. I think the competition is steeper. I think captains did a really good job this year, and it's early, so it's tough to say, but I think that it's being reflected in the standings right now. What do you think, Giant?
Am I breathing heavy now, pussies? Listen, the fact of the matter is that there is parity over here. I agree with that statement. But this is after 1.5 weeks, all right, 239 Hockey Fam? So we'll go through some of the stats today. Obviously, the top three of the top five in the standings right now, they've played six games already. So this is what's going on. But it's not even close with the first two. They're running away at 5-1, at 4-1-1. And you take a look at some of these other teams over here, and we'll go through it later. But, I mean, we got to hurry up because they're series tonight. But we'll go through it. But the Halifax Harpoons, guys like the Mighty Mongo Tards, I mean, these have tremendous players on them. And they're not doing – they don't look like they're doing that well. And you got a guy like you got a new captain like Pale Poner. And the guy's doing pretty good. The guy's doing pretty good so far. He's having a lot of fun right here, right now, Pale Poner. But this has to continue because it won't be fun for long if you're getting your asses kicked. You know what I'm saying? So what do you think thus far, Poner?
I don't know, man. I mean, the teams are pretty evenly matched. I mean, I think we had our first sweep last night was Sober's team against Agent. And that was on the fourth day of the week. So, everybody seems to be able to compete. Everybody seems like they're able to go head-to-head with one another. I know we haven't swept anybody. We played McGillis team last night. We had 2 1-goal games, one go to overtime. You know, you had the big blowout at the end there. But, I think everybody's able to compete in this league.
I agree with a lot of those points. I mean, on the parity, especially on here, you mentioned about the sweeps and stuff. Yeah, until last night, where Agent got swept, the first captain to get swept. Everybody on here has been close, tough series, a lot of overtime games, I noticed. One thing I do see, there's no donuts, man. Nobody's got a zero in that win column. You know, so, and you see that, I mean, that's really hard to see. I mean, it's a lot of times, you know, you'll have a team like 0-3 right now, but everybody's got some kind of points. There's no team with 0 points at this point. We'll see how things go on. I know it's very early on here, but I agree with a lot of your points there, Daly, as well, regards the parity. I think the captains did a great job drafting, and I think just the draft pool itself was very deep on here. We had a lot of newcomers on here, especially in the goaltending aspect, have stepped it up here. So, Anything else you guys want to touch base on that parody? Or
you mentioned that as well too. I mean, let's take a look at this. And Pale Poner, correct me if I'm wrong, but you said that this is the first time you played goalie as well. Now, you had some guy play a game, Dave the Fat Lard, and it looked like he was absolutely atrocious. 7.12 GAA in that game. That is not good. I mean, what happened over here? Do you normally play goalie? Is that your natural position or what?
I've never played goalie before. I drafted my team. I wanted to go offense first, and you know, I ended up going defense first, moreover, actually. But I was planning on playing defense for my team, and I was planning on picking up a goalie late, and it just didn't happen. I picked up a couple of guys that were willing goalies, and, you know, as you see, I tried one out, and he didn't work out all that well. I think he's still got some potential to do better, but, you know, yeah, that first game that we played, Fear the Wolf really lit us up. I think they scored 7 goals on 11 shots, and... you know, I decided to make the switch right then and there, mid-series. I decided to go in net. I had been playing net all week because I figured that there was a possibility that I was going to have to. And, yeah, I've been in net since. And
so you're saying that the Fat Lard sucked during the week when you guys were practicing too, right? Is that right?
I wouldn't say he sucked, man. I mean, you know, he moves a little bit too much in net, and that's something that we're trying to work on with him. But yeah, I mean, I was playing goalie all week and I was preparing myself for it. I already know how to play defense. I played D all last league season and, you know, that's what I've always played. But, yeah, last Tuesday I picked up goaltending and, I've been running with it.
Flanny, stand by for Yambag or somebody else bitching at you because you recruited this Fat Lard dude, you know?
Well, here's the thing.
There won't be any complaints.
That's a joke. Don't mean to pick on you, David. Relax, bro. It's all love, yo.
Damn.
It's all love, yo. Just stop sucking so much, Daly.
I haven't seen him play, so I won't comment on it.
Well, after the draft, that's one of the questions that came about, I think, on Pell's team. A lot of guys were questioning, like, who is going to be the goaltender? And, you know, some guys said Rico, other guys said Fat Lard. There was even Pell Poner's name was thrown in the mix. And that's what we've seen here this week. And it's worked. I mean, 4-1-1, debut as a captain here this season. I don't think that's bad at all, man. And the teams that you guys played, I mean, you guys played Shock's team that first opening night on there. You guys took 2 out of 3. Big win on that third game, 8-0. First shutout for you in net as well. Right, Pale?
Yeah. 8-0 win on Fear the Wolf. You know, our offense really started getting going, but the bread and butter of my team is defense. Brixit plays great defense. Derek GNR on D is fucking awesome. Beastly Jesus, I planned on putting him on D to start, but I wasn't sure whether he would work out there because I only scouted him as a forward. But he looked like he was really solid defensively, so that's where I was planning on putting him. And he's been elite, in my opinion. But so these guys are making my job real easy in net. You know, as long as I make the saves that I'm supposed to make, I think I can continue to sustain with the numbers that I'm putting up right now.
And okay, now is Brick City a personal friend of yours as well, or no?
He's a guy. He's not a personal friend. I mean, I met him online in NHL back in 2010.
He's your boy then. Yeah, but he's your
boy. Yeah, him, Notorious Vigo, C-Dub 21, you know, a couple of these new guys in the league are guys that I've played with club in for almost 7-8 years now.
All right, so he's spilling the beans right now, fellas. So you could take a look at this. A lot of these, you know, when you have this type of cohesion and you're playing with these guys all the time in club or whatever, you know, things like this, they help a lot, you know? So I think that cohesion is a big part of it, but credit to you, Pale, for getting the job done regardless, dude. You knew there was a situation here, and you decided to act on it. You took the reins head on, and, you know, you're moving on to the next series, I guess, you know? So what are you going to do? But Brick City seems like a pretty good. I don't know how good your opponents were, but what Flanny said earlier is that everybody has a win. So, you know, everybody could say at the end of week two, there's some parity, but it's going to be breaking away at some point, I would think. I think that's the way it is in professional sports, too, just to let the 239 hockey fam know. I mean, you see the Jets, you see the Bears, you know, you see the Browns. Every season, it's garbage. I mean, dumpster fire every fucking year. Go ahead, Flanny.
Yeah, man. I mean, congrats to Pill. I mean, stepping up as captain and then going between the pipes. I mean, shutouts are not easy to make. I mean, this guy's got two of them already in week number one. Two shutouts, and, you know, and you played against a tough Magillo team. I mean, Magillo always drafts a pretty solid team. You guys took that series. I know there's great chemistry between Figo and Brick. Those guys have been playing for, like, years. So that chemistry, and then you throw in Joe Stowe in the mix on there, you know. One of the questions I had, you know, I mean, because you come in net, and that leaves that defensive part, but then you take a look at a guy like Gisli Biza, Beastly Jesus. I mean, that guy can play anywhere. Like Dominator said on our previous podcast on there, I mean, you could put that guy on forward or defense. He's a very versatile type of player.
Yeah, that's what I was going to touch on next. What's it called? So Notorious Vigo, he's a cop. He works in Newark as a police officer overnight. And so he's not going to be available a whole hell of a lot. He's going to be on when he can be on for me. But, yeah, Beastly Jesus really gives me that flexibility to, you know, move him up to right wing when I need him and provide great offense as well as defense. He's really a Swiss Army knife. He can really play center well. He can go anywhere. That guy's awesome.
Man, guys like that is great to have on the team. Hey, a lot of Jersey guys you got on that team, huh?
Yeah, a couple of them, yeah.
Good, good, good. Daly, you had any questions on this team or anything on any other analysis you want to point out on the?
No, sorry, I was falling asleep while we were sitting there blowing pale after week one. I mean, fucking, your guys' lips are so firmly attached to his cock and balls. I wasn't even gonna go down that path, but I mean, yeah. Shout out to Pale, good week one. Make sure you don't blow your load in their fucking eyeballs, man. Holy shit, that was crazy. But yeah, no, I mean, it's good, you know. Again, it's nice to see that. You know, we had a lot of guys step up this season. You know, captaining's tough. It's not an easy thing to do. So to see somebody who's, you know, never done it before to get a grasp of the league after one season is great and have enough mindset and knowledge to be able to draft a team that looks like it's going to compete. So I'll give you that. But I guess I can't sit here and blow you as hard as those two did for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah. Well, there is bias in fairness. I think the bias is there due to the fact that he is from Dirty Jersey as well. And the fact that he's on the podcast with us too. So this is a first for Pale Poner too. It's interesting when you get analysis from the captain himself. You're basically interviewing him. Daly, we had that honor every fucking week last season. So that's the thing, you know. So this week,
it's true.
We have Pale Poner over here. I mean, and we hear the same stuff from you. You do good analysis, but so in fairness, that's why. So welcome to the program. Good luck the rest of the season, Pale. We'll move on, Planny, to Masters of the Universe. And
yeah. I mean, speaking about blowing guys, how about Sober Enough on here? Yeah, Master of the Universe, I believe, is the team name on here. Right now, he sits on top of the leaderboard here, 5-1-0 against a new season, new team here for Sober, but he's still on top of the ranks. Let me start with Daly on this one first. I mean, he always talks about, you know, us blowing guys around. Daly, what about Sober here, man? Are you impressed with this team, man?
You look at it, and yeah, I mean, I thought he had a good draft. I question Luca at right wing. And again, of course, here goes Sober. Oh, let me do a fucking face-off count. No one gives a fuck about the face-off count, okay? Not one person in that write-up cares about the face-off count. The fact of the matter is that Luka is the center, and you took him at 4 overall. That's why I brought it up. When I do these draft analysis, people get super butthurt when I bring this stuff up or whatever, so it's like this common goal to prove me wrong. So, great. You had a good week with Luka. He's still a centerman. Whatever. I actually like the D pair here. Baru's coming back, cocky as ever, feeling really confident about what's going on, calling people ghosts on the ice. So that seems to be working. Sniper's impressed me a lot. I like the way he plays D. He, you know, definitely likes to jump into play, move the pucks. And I think this is Thug's recovery year. I think he's going to have a good recovery year. I think he's going to, you know, he was drafted in a really nice spot. He wasn't overdrafted. McGillin messed that up last year, and I roasted him for it. But the team is very good. It's very deep. And then when you don't have Hugh Laurie, you have Zlow filling in. And Zlow doesn't have to do a lot, you know, and that's the big thing with Zlow. I find sometimes he likes to do too much, but when you're playing with Sober, you're playing with Luca, you don't have to do so much. So as long as Zlow understands that, Sober is going to be throwing out a good line every series, even with or without Hugh Laurie. So I really like how this team's constructed. I believe I said I liked how it was in my analysis. So I think this team's going to be a top three team. I think they're right where they should be. What do you think, Flanny?
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised, man. I mean, after the draft, I didn't think this team was going to be good. You mentioned about B-Rus, yeah. Doesn't look like he missed a step, man. So far in those six games that they've played. And I believe he's using him up on forward spot, not on D. I mean, this guy's got, it looks like 14 points already here in this season. Sober enough, right back at that leaderboard with the goals. 13 goals, 9 assists, 22 points. Giant, what do you think, man? I mean, with this Sober enough, you're a big Sober fan, man. Are you still staying on that bandwagon this year, man?
There's no question. I don't know what happened to Sober. It's like he went from one of the lowest players in the league, like, in a league, to like being MVP contention. He definitely won the MVP last season. I don't know where he got it, but shout out to Sober again. Once again, it looks like he's got a fantastic team. I'm in complete agreement with Daly over here. Side note, I just want to give a quick shout out to the people in chat, and I know we are in a podcast, but there's a lot of people in chat, so I just want to give them shout outs. Phoenix Rising, Cosmic Fade, Dank Love, No Cause Red Renegade, Sober Enough, and Shock, a.k.a. The Plug, right? And correct me if I'm wrong. I didn't know he's Canadian either, but shout out to the guys that were in chat. They're in there. They are in there a lot. This team is going to have no issues whatsoever getting into the playoffs. Pale, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, Sober's a great forward. I don't know a whole lot about Stealth Luka. He's probably one of those old school guys that I've never really seen play. He wasn't in the league last year. But I mean, he's on top of the leaderboard. So yeah, he's doing great. Sober's doing what he did last year. I agree with Daly. I think Thug is going to have a great year. I mean, I was on his team to start the year last year. I know he got traded a couple of times and ended up having to play either the Thundercats or Jello Time about four or five times. That really hurt him a lot, you know. But I think he's going to have a big bounce back year. I've played with Roos a couple of times. He seems like he's a good player, both defense and offense. Yeah, I mean, I expect them to be at the top of the leaderboard all year.
Yeah, then you got Thug CTC in net for him there. By the way, he didn't have a great highlight reel there for one of those games. I think Hugh Laurie off the face-off circle scored on his own net. But besides that, yeah, I mean, 5-1-0, man. 10 points right now. It has that one-point advantage against you there, Pell, in the standings. And one of the teams that played six. We got a lot of teams playing here tonight to finish up the week one. But let's jump from the top of the board. I want to look towards the bottom. I'm talking about the ninth and the tenth team. And are you guys surprised here? I mean, coming into this draft, I think these two guys were one of the two favorite captains before the draft even took place. I'm talking about D-Mar. And I'm talking about also
Drift King.
Drift King, yes. Both of them losing their first series. Are you guys surprised with the outcome on there with either one of those teams? That'll be the Justice League.
Well, I guess
League,
and the Harpoons,
Halifax,
right?
Yes. Which I believe they actually play tonight, man. They play tonight. in a series. So one of these two teams is still going to stay on the bottom if they lose this series.
Well, I think the Mongo Tards are actually playing Drift Kings team, so we got them tonight. I'm not sure who the Harpoons are playing, but you know, it's weird. Like, you look at DeMart's draft. You know, again, him and Marty up front seem to be really solid. DeMart is a pest in himself. I like Dank Love on that line. I think Dank Love is playing left wing, though. I think that's his off wing, so that might play a little bit of a role. I like Johnny Blaze. I like Ed. Neither one of them stands out as a number one D, but you got two nice number twos. I liked where he drafted Johnny Blaze. I actually liked where he drafted Ed as well. Ability in net, man, it's just one of those young goalies, those first-time goalies, and you don't know what you're really going to get. So there's a lot of question marks on DeMart's team. I liked his draft just because he was on it and he got his brother, and I love their forward lineup. But then you look at it, 6 goals, 3 games. They scored 10 goals in 3 games. So 3 a game, it's about on par, but they still lost, you know. So that tells me that defensively and in net, there are some question marks. So, again, the Harpoons, I'm not so sure about. I think they're, you know, maybe a bubble team now, and I think I had them a little bit higher. As far as Justice League, I still think they're going to be the team to beat. I still think they're a top team. You got Lefty Golfer in net, a.k.a. I'm not the Skyrid is his name now. Defensively, you got Kayla back there. She's, you know, solid as hell. Up front, Esoteric, Drift King, and Superstar. I know you guys both love Superstar, and he's back in the league now too. So the big question mark on this team is going to be, can the forwards really get that chemistry? I said it in the last show we did. You know, there's only one puck. Drift likes to have it. Superstar likes to have it, but there's only one. So are these guys going to learn to play without it? I think it's a very underappreciated skill set in this game. I think some of the best players in this game are good without the puck, and I think it's again an undervalued trait. So that'll be the big question mark here. I still think they're going to be a top team. I'll send it over to Pale. Pale, I don't know if you played these guys yet, but looking at the roster and being in the league last year, what do you think about the Justice League? That's Drift's team.
No, I haven't played him yet this year. So Drift King, I've never seen play forward. He played goalie last season. You say he's pretty elite, even, but a guy that wants the puck. And then I know Superstar is the same kind of guy, so they may have a similar issue as somebody like Agent's team, who's got Cosmic Fade and McSwagger, who hasn't played yet. But, you know, two guys that can score at will by themselves. They don't really need somebody else to make things happen. You have two guys on the forward line like that, and it becomes predictable, easy to shut down. But I mean, Drift King's got Esoteric on the team. He was one of the guys that I really wanted in my draft. He's playing center, where I would have played him at center. I think
that's his natural. That's his natural position, by the way.
Yeah, I mean, he was great on the dot. He was playing great defensively. I mean, the guy's a machine. He's only got 4 points in the first series, but I know that first series they played McGilla's team, and McGilla's team is pretty stout defensively. We just played them last night. We had 2 games go, you know, 1-goal games, 1 in overtime, and they were missing Moose, who's his number one pick and his defensive partner. So, I mean, I know that these guys probably will be able to score. I'm just not sure whether they're going to be able to move the puck and become more dynamic to be able to sustain and rise up from where they're at right now.
Yeah, man. I mean,
all right. So take a look at this. Take a look at the Halifax Harpoons. DeMar is among the best players in the world, I think. Okay, so a guy can't be getting 8 points in a series over here with his own brother, and he's got Dank Love up top. On paper, these guys should be destroying stuff up front, and it's not happening. So I guess it's only one series, but we'll see, fellas. I'd be a little bit concerned at this point. Quickly on Justice League, I think they'll get into the playoffs. I don't know how far, but I don't know. These guys, too, they're not scoring anything. It's like they can't even... I don't understand this. I really don't. Are the defenses that they played against that incredible or what, guys? I mean, I don't understand
I'm
this pale.
To what Giant's saying, I'm just going to elaborate. To what you're saying, Giant, I think the Justice League's issues are going to be how do the forwards play without the puck? There's no question that they're going to possess it. There's no question they have skilled players. I played with Esso all last year. He's a good buddy of mine, one of my best friends. He knows how to play without the puck because I've seen it. I saw it all last year. Drift and Superstar will struggle without the puck because they've always been in situations where they've had the puck. So that's the problem, is they get lost in these situations when they don't have it. And it's so important. Like, I can't even stress it enough. You got to know where you're going. If you don't have it, you make that pass, you're not standing still. You got to know where you're going. And I just think it's a very underrated attribute. And I think it's something that is a weakness of Superstar. And as good as Drift is, I think it is a weakness of his as well. So I think that until those guys figure out how to play without the puck, they're going to struggle offensively. So we'll hopefully they can figure it out. Hopefully they can. What do you think, Flanny?
Well, so far that offense has been struggling. You look at this team. I mean, defensively, great. Rev Hellcat, BC Wren on defense, shut down, and a guy like Esso, backchecking there, been solid. And then you got even the goaltender, Lefty, coming in here. He still looks pretty solid himself. But at offense, I mean, we're used to Esoteric on here putting up mad points, whether it's assists or goals. You look at 4 points only. But the big question mark, the biggest one on here daily that I see, Superstar himself. Here's a guy, beta season, led the league in points, goals, you know. He's got zero. I'm talking about zero goals, zero assists, 0 points, man, you know. And if that happens, they're not winning games, man. They're not winning at all. I don't care how good this defense is. 5 goals in 3 games, and Superstar getting shut out. I mean, shut out completely, man. Maybe this guy should have stayed retired. I don't know, Daly. Maybe he's got to go between the pipes.
The thing is with Soup, it's going to be against the good Ds, how he does. I like the guy. I really do. We've had many conversations. Him and I have talked about this. I feel like sometimes he just tries to do too much. And if he simplifies his game a little bit more, yes, make those flashy dekes. But when you do them all the time and you do them against good D-men, it's not going to work. The windmills and the between the legs and all that silly shit does not work against good D-men. I'm sorry. It doesn't. And especially if you're oversaturating it. So simplify your game. That's why Esoteric was so good last year. And I'm not just saying it because he's on my team, but he played such a simple game. He got into the third in the league in goals. He got into the soft spots on the ice. He got set up, and he scored because he was doing what he was supposed to do. He knew how to play without the puck, and he knew he was going to get the puck. I feel that if this team does that, and they really settle in, and they really understand what's going on, and they play without the puck, I think they're going to be the top team in the league. But if they can't figure that out and they can't get the chemistry, they're fucked. They are fucked because you have two guys who want the puck all the time. So, again, simple, simple, simple. The skill set's there. Play a simple game. That's all I got to say on it.
I mean, right now, Daly, True Therapy has more points than Esoteric and Superstar combined. You know, who would have thought that right now for that case to be? But yeah, definitely struggling defense. I don't think D-Mart's team, they only played that one series, still putting points. I mean, I look at Dank. I mean, did he go too early on here? I mean, and Marty McFly, 1 goal, 5 assists. I know he's not really a goal scorer, does pass the puck around, 6 points for both of those. But I think they'll get it right. I don't see D-Mart's team. I'll be definitely real surprised if they wouldn't make playoffs. But Drift's team, man, I mean, I thought he had one of the solid drafts, but your theory or your analysis on their daily about that one puck, both guys wanting to have it. Right now, it's time to get Steven, who's getting any points, and Superstar is not. So, definitely not working out. Speaking about struggling teams, man, one of the other teams I want to get into this podcast, I'm talking about Agents team. The only team that got swept on here was last night, I believe, in the hands of Pale Poner here. Sober's team. Sober's team. Sweep some. Is it time, Giant? Is it time for the panic button on you? Now, I know Swagger has not played yet a single game here yet for this team. They came out. They won the first series. They're opening a series there. They did have Jimbo, a waiver, come in there for him, luckily for Agent there, because another guy that's not on the team right now is Soldier Up, you know. DJ, he's out
for
2 weeks.
He's not even in the country yet.
2 weeks,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, he's not in the country.
So you got
Where's
one guy.
Where's McSwagger? Where did McSwagger go? I don't even
Swagger's
remember.
Swagger's in Florida,
on the draft.
Man. He's in Florida, but he's, I think, coming back next week. So good for that.
He must be richer. He must have a rich fucking wife because, yo, for every U.S. dollar, it's like 73 cents to the dollar. So listen to my fellow Americans, if you got some loot, and you got your passport, go to Canada because you could live like a fucking king or queen there for a couple of days, man. Niagara Falls, they got the Pro Hockey Hall of Fame, I think, up there. You know what's cool, too? Oh, man, Montreal's got some cool places, too, man. It's been so long, but make sure you send it. So he must have a rich wife, but, hey, McSwagger, you got to get back, bruh, okay? You're not a baby anymore. Things are happening over here. Your team is not doing well without you, all right, bro? Pale, what are your thoughts on this so far, on their season?
Yeah,
I wouldn't panic yet.
We haven't really seen Agent's team play yet. You know, McSwagger's a big part of that team. He drafted him with his third pick. It was a second-round pick. It was late, but, I mean, you're expecting him to be a guy that's going to be a big part of the offense. How it works, I don't know. I know Cosmic can make things happen. I played with him all last season. He's the type of guy that's going to be able to score at will. He's a guy that can beat you one-on-one and score himself. And I played a couple of scouting games with McSwagger, too. He's the type of guy that can do that, too. I don't know. They're also missing Eye Soldier Up. They've gotten two good D-men. I think they had Jimbo and... I don't know. They had another waiver that was pretty decent. I saw. Yeah. So I mean, yeah. I don't know what to say about Agent's team so far because we haven't seen his whole roster play yet.
Okay. Oh, what about you, Daly, man? We're talking about Agent's team. We're talking about is McSwagger the answer? Is things gonna change when this guy comes in the lineup, or when 2 weeks when we got DJ, or is this team gonna struggle? Is this a preview of what's to come for Agent's team? Gonna send it at 2-3-1 here right now, or it's still early, Daly? What do you think?
Yeah, no, it's early, and again, not having your his draft did not help him for week one, but that's okay. Go 2-3-1. You take 5 points week one. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. That's about as equivalent to a 3-3 as it gets. That's about an even split. I'm okay with that week. Obviously, the 8-0 or no, I'm sorry, different series, but obviously getting swept hurts. You don't want to see that ever. You just don't. But Pale made a good point. Doesn't have his full lineup yet. I'm not ready to, you know, tap in on these guys yet. Think it was a bad first or a decent first week. You can definitely rebound from a 2-3-1. I think these guys are going to be fine. You know, you look at the lineup. I love No Cause. Everybody knows that he's one of my favorite D-men in the league. Not just as a person, but as a player. I think he's just kind of the total package. I think Cosmic Fade took a big step last year. Again, defense is going to be an issue. Unless these guys figure it out, I'm looking at it, you know, minus 12, minus 13, you know, that's tough. Getting McSwagger back is definitely going to help with the goal differential, but I don't think it's going to help with the defense. And that's what I said in my analysis. So I think that if this team can really, you know, band together and focus on the defensive aspect of the games, I think naturally they have the skill set to score enough goals that it's not going to matter. So my biggest thing, the Agents team and going to send it roster, let the offensive plays come to you. You guys are skilled enough that you'll be able to create your offense. I don't think that you need to, you know, fly the zone so much and try and do those things. I'm thinking of McSwagger. I'm thinking of Cosmic Fade. These are good players that don't need to do that. So, again, it's going to be interesting to see how McSwagger gels with these guys, but I think it should be fairly easy. No Cause is literally one of the most chill dudes I know. Played with McSwagger last year, so I'm sure he'll be okay. And the other guys seem to fit in really nicely. So I think it'll be okay.
They got a big-time
right,
goalie back there
this...
in Metagaron, too.
Yeah, we got to wrap this gavel up, man. Flanny, you got any finalizing statements over
here,
or what, man?
Yeah. But yeah, the goaltender I love. I love the goaltender agents team. That's one guy that I really like on that team. We'll see. Time will tell. I mean, when he gets the full roster, we'll see on there. But yeah, snatching 5 points with two of your starters out is pretty good in itself. Let's move on. I want to discuss. I promised we were going to talk about it, and that's Daily Island, man. We had great posts on there, on the write-up, on the front page there of the series. I'm talking about Yanbag's team against Legion. Daily, you were in that series, so was I, man. Can we give a recap of that series, man?
Yeah, I mean, let's start by saying this before we get into that. That was a tight series, man. Every game decided by one goal, I believe. Shout out to you. Shout out to Legion. I thought you guys both played great. I thought it was a really tight series all around. It was crazy. Like one team would score, the other team would score, and it was a fun series to go with the parody topic that we talked about earlier. As far as the island and what that entails. First of all, everybody was literally Boner City when Edge hit a windmill. What everybody thought was against the island, but it was against Thamps. So Thamps got walked like really bad. And Thamps, shout out to Thamps. I love him. He used to play D, but he doesn't anymore. He's a forward now. So get rid of that goal that Thamps let Edge walk him. Edge had 4 points in 3 games. I mean, listen, man, you could call it what you want. 2 goals, 2 assists in 3 games. In the real NHL, that's probably pretty good. But 4 points in 3 games in NHL 17, man, you know what? I'll hashtag it. Hashtag welcome to the island, man. 4 points in 3 games is generally not going to get it done. But I'll leave it at that. You guys can make whatever you want of it. I know what I bring to the table. I know that it is an absolute nightmare to go up against the island. So I'll leave it at that, and you guys can have whatever rhetoric say that you want, because Jim Flanagan's the biggest troll ever. Go ahead.
Hey, but the records on here, Daily, between one Mr. Hollywood, one Daily, does not favor Daily so much lately, man. I'm talking about last season. I'm talking about this season.
We'll say hashtag playoff dodge, and we'll leave it at that, and we'll just be done with it.
But I agree now. That series was definitely close, man. That first game, actually double overtime. Legion came up with a huge save. I mean, he robbed Dominator Silva to hell, man. But unfortunately, you guys couldn't get the win in that game. Game two, I thought I came up with tremendous save against Sabby, but we didn't get the win there. So you guys took it, and it came down to that game three rubber game there. Your points on there about the points, and we had 10 goals for, you guys had 9. So one difference in the goal there. Hopefully we see you guys in the playoffs as well. Always a great battle, man, there with you. You know, I know Dom loves playing. And I mean, that whole series was tremendous. Great job by Legion, man. Legion, I didn't think he had it, but he came out with some big saves. But he also did come out with some big goals that shouldn't have went in. So hopefully you guys get that figured out on there if we meet you guys. I know tonight's another big series. You got Mr. Hollywood going up against former ally there, Chubbs Reborn, man. That all happens tonight. Daly, I know you got your series there as well. And there's one more other series there. I think that was the Harpoon series. That's all I got on that. Anything else you guys want to add before we wrap it up? I know it's almost 10 Eastern here. Guys, we're on scrimmage, going to drop in. Anything else to add on there, Daly or Pale?
No, man. You know, I fucking probably just cursed the hell out of my life because I'm going up against Superstar and Drift tonight and all that one puck talk I
yes.
did. And,
yes.
You know, so
yes.
Yeah. So I did all that and I'm going against them tonight. But, you know, again, like I said, we'll get a real indication of what's happening and what's going on. So I'm excited. Always like a challenge, man. I never stray away from a challenge. So
you know what, Daly? That's a series I'm actually rooting for you, man. Surprisingly.
Oh, you're rooting for
You're
rooting for the island tonight?
I actually am, you know what I mean? hopefully you guys keep Superstar shut down, man.
All right, well, we're going to try our best. Legion.
He's on your side, right? He's going to be on the other side.
Superstar's on the island tonight, so we'll see how it goes.
Oh, man. That'll be interesting, man. Get us some good highlights, man. Get some good highlights.
I'm gonna try my best.
Speaking about highlights, yeah. I wanted to.
You're gonna be tuning any of the games tonight or what?
Am I breathing too heavy, bitches?
Here we go.
Yo, so listen, nah.
No, he's gonna be on COD. He's gonna be on Call of Duty. He's gonna be on Call of Duty.
I'm not playing that either, man. I'm going back to the NFL draft, guys. We unexpectedly came on Xbox, but the sound quality is typically fantastic as well. Everybody's on the same level playing field over here, so the interface that Xbox provides is very good to do this podcast or whatever. I'd rather us do face to face, but this is all we have for today, fellas. So, we appreciate you listening. If you check us out at 239 Hockey on Facebook, click on subscribe or check out some of the videos over there. You can click on the likes. We appreciate that as well. So lots of things going on over here at 239 Hockey. Flanny?
Yeah, absolutely. I want to thank Pell Poner coming on the show. Always great having you here, man. You're always welcome to join in. If anybody else, too, wants to be part of the podcast, think you have good analysis, like 1X Daily here, feel free to come on. But besides that, yeah, I just want to mention about the highlights, man. We had some tremendous highlights, hopefully get those sent in as well. That does it over here. Jim Flanagan, Pell Poner, Mr. Giant 918, and X Daily. Signing out, fellas.
Have a good night, everyone.
See you guys.
Have a good one, man. Thanks for having me. Hip, hip. Hip, hip.